Dear gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have brought us together. We thank you that you brought us into a company where we get to develop in and to become the best version of ourselves. We thank you where we get to come together to lift each other up. On this, the meeting before seminar, we thank you for our chance that we get to celebrate each other, not in competition, but in a chance to just celebrate the way that you are working in each other's life and totally understanding that if you do it for one, you will do it for all. And help us to lean into those miracles. Help us to take you at your word and be willing to dare more. Be with our trainers tonight. Be with us as directors that our words can get to people's ears, to elicit the heart, to give us a chance to see you more clearly and definitely love more dearly. We ask this in your Son, our Savior's name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, Miss Judy, we are going to turn it over to you to get started with I'm going to go ahead and mute. If you will, go ahead and mute so that we're not going to get back feeding since we are recording. So if you would be so kind, if everybody would just go ahead and mute, and then when we go to talk, we're going to go ahead and unmute. So Miss Judy, you're...
All right. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You know, I was excited, and then she prays, and I get so excited, I just nearly don't know how to behave. But, that, you know, isn't it marvelous to get to be excited? I have to tell you real quick, I've been in physical therapy, and as they were working with my neck today, the gentleman was talking to me, and I told him I had a Zoom meeting tonight. And he said, oh, please don't sit there for an hour or better looking just right at the screen. Take a break and, you know, do my exercise and that kind of stuff. And I said, oh, you don't understand. This is with Mary Kay people. Nobody just stares at the screen. We get so excited, we just bounce all over the place. So, you know, welcome to bouncing off the wall, because the week before seminar is always that kind of a week. And I have a quote for you that I'd like for you to think about with me this evening as we start our evening. If you fear what people will think or say about you more than what God will think or say about you when you are working your business or making decisions, it is doubtful if you will fulfill your purpose. Now, all of us kind of really and truly have a purpose, a direction, a goal, whatever it is at that moment that you're wanting to talk about. And if we are truly following what God has put together through Mary Kay so that there's a process that we can work with to make things happen, and it is a proven process, then the only thing we have to release or let go of is fear. And I hope that in this week of seminar that you're going to find someone that has given you a speech, a word, a phrase, sometimes it's even just one word, and that's your word to take home from seminar. And as you take it and you work with it, then you release fear. Because remember the acronym, fear is just false evidence appearing real. And so we're going to talk about for a moment our recognition for the evening. Now, if those of you that are new, remember that down in the chat, you're going to privately text me, and we have five areas that you're going to text me. Oops, sorry, let's turn the pretty side over. Five areas. You're going to text me how many faces you've seen this past week, how many new bookings you have, what your sales were, how many career chats or interviews you've done, and how many new team members. So, faces, bookings, sales, interviews, and team building, I mean, new team members, okay? And that's what you're going to privately text to me on the chat. And while you're doing some of that, I'm going to talk about a couple of our new products because I am so excited, I can hardly stand it, over what some of these are going to be like. Now, I want to start off with Ditch Dullness. Now, I had a hard time with that title until I began to work with this particular product. And it is a little purple stick, and it is to brighten the face, help the tired eyes to not appear such. And one of the fun things that I have found about it, if you will notice, I'm going to use you as my mirror. Da-da-da. Uh-oh, my mirror just got smaller. Somebody else came on. Now, you can see it's kind of purple right now, but then you would either take your cream blush, because you want to stay right in that nasal labral fold, and you want to stay right there, and notice the difference between this side and this side. Is that not exciting, gang? Is that not simple? And now one thing about it is that we do have a limit that we can order on these. Just a moment, I'm gonna make sure I'm correct. Yes, we only get to order 5. And let me rest you assured, don't bother to try to say I'll order 2 now and then I'll order 2 later and then I'll order 2 more. They won't let you order 2 that third time. It is strictly 5 that we can have right now. The company has worked very hard to give us these products to where that we can work with our customers. And so I really encourage you to think about how that can happen, even with the limitations that we will work with. Because, ooh, I can promise you, the company's working with those limitations. And then, of course, as you all know, we have something else. And I talked a little bit about this Saturday, so I apologize if you were there Saturday and you have to see it again. This is the Cream Blush Duo Stick. Now, how this works is that there is both a smooth side or a matte and a shimmer. The beauty of that is that as you're using the end of it, you've got the two of them. So that, now I put that on a little bit heavy. So that again, you can see how simply a cream blush goes on. Now, if you get too much, you use the thumb of your thumb, the flat of your thumb, and you pull. And that makes it all fit in. See? Okay. Let's see. I have a tissue around here. Now, that was the mauve shimmer. And we also have the pink glitter. For those of you that like a more subtle look, this is certainly one that can work. Now, don't I look brighter already? A little bit heavy on that side. Sorry, gang. But when you're in my mirror, it's a little bit interesting to see all of you looking back at me. But I am crazy about both of those. And of course, there definitely is a limit on those. And that is that you can have 2 per shade. You need 1 for demoing. And now I'm thinking that when we're in person, face-to-face, which is going to be the only way that we can demo this, we will simply scrape a little bit off and let them apply it, okay? Between here and there, you may want to do something like I just did and demo it for them. Now, I would suggest it not be after you've already got some on and your foundation. You know, this does go on top of your foundation, and I love the fact that our purple can go on top of the foundation. It is recommended underneath, but I think it is more lifting on top. So play with it and see. And then, of course, we have the fun new lip glosses. They're going to come in 14 different shades, yes, but they come in 3 different finishes, a cream, a pearl, and a shimmer. Now, I noticed that the majority of the colors are a cream. I have on the Iconic Red tonight only over the red lip liner. This is a gorgeous look. It goes on, it gives enough color by itself over the liner. I've also worn it over my sparkling red. That's not quite the right name. But the red lipstick, and it shows up marvelously. It is a great way to teach them how to pull the areas that are more limited or thinner up to where they are more symmetrical. Sorry about that. I know better than an So I apologize. And then, of course, the other fun thing that we have are the eyeshadows. Now, you talk about being able to go from your day to play to that sparkling night. having these in someone's purse would just absolutely allow them, if they've been going to work, leave work, put a little bit of right here, and especially in your gold or pyrite, or if they've been wearing, of course, pinks, and tonight I was not wearing pinks, but pinks and mauves in this one. It lifts, and yet it will harmonize and add a brilliance to the eyes. Now, these also have a limit of 5 per shade. So we will work with the company in helping them to know that we appreciate the fact that they've gotten some of them to us, and that it will continue to work through as they can reach the ingredients. Because let me assure you, they want us to have these. They would like for us to have 10 of everything and be able to sell it all at that time. And let me encourage you, play with these. Now, when you're looking at something like Evening Berry, a lot of people think, but it would be Mary's color. Because once it's on, it is not as strong as what it is in the container. Plus, as you will notice, they have definitely reshaped our applicator. Therefore, it fits into the corners of the mouth better and gives us more coverage. So, we've got a tremendous amount of reasons to call our customers. And your PCP that you signed up for in July will be featuring these products. You will want your book. And you want your book to go out to all of your customers. Now, if you were not in at that time, I encourage you to order a few of these books so that you've got the product pictures to show your customers. Any questions, gang? Are you falling in love with our duo cheek colors? They are so simple. They are so simple. And of course, cream or pearl or shimmer. Which one will you wear? Or will you wear all three at one time? That will be for another lesson.
All three.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I love it if you ever said all three.
Miss Kathy, a couple tips I have for right now with us limited on your lip glosses. I have extra doe foot applicators. And so I haven't used the new applicator on my face yet. So I am just putting in a doe foot applicator and using the color. And then of course throwing the applicator away so that mine and my tester is the same too.
Yeah. And okay. That's a beautiful way to do it and meet all of the health criteria.
Okay, because that way, and right now I am only, as you notice, Miss Judy had 3 of them. She had a cream, she had a shimmer, and she had a pearl. She had one in each of the different ones. I am also limiting the shading. So basically I am testing 3 colors. I'm testing 1 in each of them because we have a limited amount that we can order. Because, you know, hey, if they get to try it and they like it, I would really like to get it in their hand. I would like to sell it. And if I've used all 15 of them as my testers, and a lot of them you can order 1, you have nothing to sell. So I'm just giving you a couple things. I saw, Lena, I saw you ask, when do we think ordering quotas are going to be moved? Okay, so that you know, 1, they put an ordering quota on so that everybody had a chance to get some. We, as directors, understand we've had these products for over 2 weeks. And if given us the chance, we would have bought a whole lot more. I'll just be honest. We would have bought a lot more than we got to. I have never just bought 1 lip gloss. Or any 1 lip product when it first comes out. That's usually more like 10 to 12. Mm-hmm. So the reality is, they're, from what I understand, they're gonna be giving us about another week to allow people a chance to order. And then they're gonna look at the inventory. And then they're gonna go, okay, fair game. Everybody can order one or two, whatever. They are trying to keep the playing field so that a director and a new consultant were trying to keep it that everybody can keep the playing field even. So just to let you know, thanks to COVID, and it's more, understand, Mary Kay is still packaging hand sanitizer. So we are not in full-fledged production of product. We still have a line running hand sanitizer because that is still a definite need in the universe. So we're not at full. And then you also have to think about it. We don't manufacture the tube. That is a third party. So some of those third party sources are not open. So same reason that, you know, hey, some of us have earned a car. We're waiting for the company to build it. It's not that Mary Kay doesn't want to give it to us. Mary Kay doesn't make the car. So just be thankful. But as a business owner, you also just means thinking outside the box. Well, what does this mean? How do we do things? I loved, you know, Judy's suggestion. Hey, this is my tester. It's what I'm using, but I'm leaving the other ones up for sale. I'm not having mine and a tester. We're safely doing that as well. We're doing a little bit more, you know, glowing and showing. So,
And one more thing, that you have samples of the new lip glosses now that you can order on section two. Mm-hmm. And so again, you can take those and your doe
foot applicator.
Thank you. I kept saying doe tail and that just wasn't right. Doe foot applicators. And that can be how you're showing people. And you could even do that in your purse as you're out and about and around. Oh,
And right.
Can I put this on your hand?
Right. And the same is true about at some point they will release the number of samples you can get, but it's the same thing. We're trying to have it that everybody has a shot at it. They're trying to make it that everybody has a shot at ordering product. Yeah. I'm just going to call it what it is. We're trying to keep it that we can all play and things like that. Okay. Yes, I totally agree. Doesn't her red look totally awesome on her lips? Yes, we're going to vote yes. We love it.
Thank you.
Can't you wait till it's your chance that you get to do that as well. Okay, so now please private message. I did put the categories over in the chat if you forgot what they were. Please private message Miss Judy Stats. That way it's just more of a surprise. If you didn't, it's fine. But that's why we asked for a private message to Miss Judy, that she can be kind of going through that. I'm gonna turn it over to the amazing hustler. No, well she is, but that's a good compliment. I am so excited about what she is going to be training on because this is what I would say is, I don't know, Facebook. You know, some people believe that Mark Zuckerberg invented it. But in reality, those of us who have been Mary Kay for a long time, we actually believe that Mary Kay invented Facebook because she said if they got within 3 feet, book them. So Facebook. So anyway, but I will tell you, she's kind of the queen of it. Yes, she did earn her first Diamond Bee, Bumblebee, and being in the company, just for the record, she earned that Diamond Bumblebee. And she wasn't even in the company a full 12 months. And she still earned her Bumblebee her first year in Mary Kay. And she is more than on target for number two. So I don't know about you, but I think I want to turn up my ears a little bit. I think I want to find my notebook. I want to find my pen. What and how? What and how? So Miss Sophia, we would love to know a what and a how you find all these lovely people.
Okay. All right. Hello, everybody. Good evening. My name is Sophia. Basically, it's something that I have incorporated in my day. I have Mary Kay in my day. It is with me everywhere I go. I have full-size product in my purse. I am ready at the drop of a hat. I have a printed agreement in my bag. so that I can hand it to someone who is excited about the product. I also have samplers. I'm the queen of samplers and catalogs. Okay, because every face, every place is an opportunity. From the minute I get out of my car, if I drive up to the gas station and I see a lady at the fuel pump inside of the service center, well, she's sitting there all for a full 8 hours. And yes, you know, people do play on their phone, but they get tired of that. You know, you can hand them a catalog, introduce yourself. And what basically what I do is I go in and I say hi and I get a conversation started. Sometimes it's about the mask, you know. Sometimes it's about, well, you know, they might be complaining about how warm their mask is. I've got something for that. They might be complaining about how, they might be talking about how the hand sanitizer dries out their hands. You know, I might start up a conversation and say, I wonder how many times you hit that hand sanitizer every day. You know, have you ever been, you know, oh yeah, I do this all the time. It just dries out my hands. I've got something for that. That is, it's just a way that I can introduce the product and introduce what I do. Or I walk up and I, and a lot of times I'll ask, have you heard of Mary Kay? Have you ever heard of Mary Kay? I happen to sell Mary Kay. And the response I get is, sometimes it can be, I have a Mary Kay consultant. Great. Fantastic. You know, and then, you know, I move the conversation to something else because, of course, we do not step in on someone else's customer. Okay. Sometimes I hear, yes, I used to buy Mary Kay. I've lost contact with my consultant. I don't know where to find her, but I love this product or love that product. I have something for that. And what I do is I carry samplers, little samples, and I also, you can do it different ways. I put some in a Ziploc baggie. I have some old catalogs, okay? And this also is an opportunity because what I do is I will hand out the catalog and the sample, and I'll say, well, you know, that is, during COVID, we were just really struggling for catalogs, and now they're coming out with new ones. Can I put you on my customer list to get the new one? And so that's where I get a name, a number, and an address, sometimes an email, because sometimes it works better. And so I will give them the, and I put it in a canvas bag if I can. It's kind of cute, and everybody loves it. So that's another way that I do it. I carry these little canvas bags with the samples and the Ziploc baggies in there. And then I write down, I keep their name and their number. And from there on, they are my customer. I consider them my customer. And I put them on my list because we've discussed product and they told me how much they love Mary Kay. And so I consider them my customer. And then sometimes it's, like I said, the fuel station, in line at the grocery store or at the cashier's counter or the cashier's, the customer service page. It just depends, you know, where I am, whether or not I can strike up a conversation. Sometimes you'll go to the same places every day, the grocery store, you see new faces there, you know. Sometimes the restaurants, waitresses, cashiers, I've mentioned, the bank. The bank is another place where you have, people are on, aren't always sitting right there working. You know, there's a little break room in there. And it's kind of, you know, in a little enclosed area, or a little area where they can sit and they can look through a catalog. Anyway, that is how I incorporate it into my day. And it's just anybody that I happen to meet, anybody that I happen to see wearing a mask and is a little uncomfortable with that mask, anybody that is still, and you know, that I can strike up a conversation with. That's pretty much how I do it. It's the where, wherever I'm at, and the who is whoever I see in front of me. and whoever I can talk to. And the what is just the samplers and the catalogs and writing and keeping track of everybody I talk to. Just keeping good records and keeping track of those folks.
Excellent, Sophia, excellent. We're gonna do a little breakout stuff on this in just a second, but I want you to hear, she didn't do the, okay, she goes to the bank. She doesn't just take a photo with her phone. She goes into the store. Okay? She is purposely getting outside. She's purposely getting outside. Does that make sense? Because how many of you like me can actually, if you want to, spend the entire time inside your house? You don't have to leave the house. How many people like me don't absolutely have to leave the house? It's your choice, okay? If you want, so part of the training, we're gonna be doing something else in a little bit, but part of this is, I don't know about you, but has anybody come banging on your door saying, do you sell Mary Kay?
No.
Okay, so, part of this is I wanted you to hear, we still have to go to help them find us. Okay, everybody didn't say yes to her, but part of it is we need to go see, find them. We are blessing agents. I don't know about you, how many people like getting stuff for free? Is she charging for these books? Nope. Is she charging for the samples? Nope. She's a blessing agent. She's out handing out gifts. She's a gifter. Okay? So when you're going out, you're gifting. Maybe that's a mindset for you as well. You're a gifting. God's allowing you to be a gifter. Okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to try to jump, because I'm getting so much better at this. We're going to try to jump into our rooms again. So a little bit when we get to the rooms, remember, when I send you out, you have to say yes, you'll get in the room. Okay, you have to accept the room. Otherwise, you don't actually get there. If there's a director in there, they'll help take care of you. If there's not, somebody take care of it. Because eventually, I don't always get there very quickly. So just kind of take care of it. Okay, so what I would like to happen in the rooms, the first time in the rooms, we're gonna be brainstorming a list of safe places to go, okay? Where are places you actually can leave the house to go? So we're just trying to come up with a list, okay? Where are places once we go outside the house? So once you leave the front door, so anything past your front door is fair game to put on the list. Everybody understand what we're doing in our room, okay? I believe it's 2 minutes in the room. So you and your group have 2 minutes to come up with as many things, many places that we can go outside our front door, okay? So we're gonna go to breakout rooms. There are gonna be three rooms. Remember, please accept. Please get to the room. We'll see you back here in a few minutes. Ready, set, bye. Sophia's there. And we're back in the main session. At least that's what my room says. Main session. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to jump between the rooms. Somebody can help us come up with this. So basically, I'm hoping that you all are kind of writing these names down as well. So we're just going to kind of go room one gets to say a name, then room two gets to say a name, room three gets to say a name, then we'll go back up to room one. Okay. If it's been said, don't say it again. It's a great idea. We know it's a great idea. Some of these things are going to be repeated. I mean, that you probably had it on the list. So we're going to keep going to come up with some of these creative different ones. Okay, room one.
Sophia, go ahead.
Okay, I have one I forgot to mention, karaoke.
Karaoke.
Karaoke night.
Okay, so since we're going to have fun with some of the fun ones first, room two, which is where I was, laundromats. Hey, if you guys are going for the creative ones, we're going to go there right there with you. Okay, room three.
Not sure if that was us or not, but grocery stores or dentist?
Grocery, one at a time.
Oh, grocery stores.
Excellent. Okay, we're going to come back up. Now you can say dentist's office. So there you go. Room two, we're going to also say at your job. Room one?
The gun show.
The Ooh. Gun show. Excellent. Room one, come back to you.
Oh, dog park.
Dog park, excellent. Estheticians. Room three.
Daycares.
Daycare, excellent. Come get another one.
Churches.
Churches, excellent. We also said post office. Mm-hmm. Okay, room one.
Hairdresser. That's one I did excellent. Today.
You get number one, we'll zig back. Number one, give us another one.
Lizette, go ahead.
Your kids' sports events, you know?
Absolutely. Some sporting events are back on, okay? I'm going to pick on Toya because I know where she is because we've talked today. You know, people going back, she's dropping kids at colleges. So we're talking, what are you doing on these college campuses? Okay, we've got some of these people actually on campuses. So what are we doing with that? Room three.
Plasma centers, like okay. Donating blood or plasma locations okay. Right now.
Excellent, health centers like that. Okay, you get to come back with another one?
I think that was all the ones that we had.
I think that was all we had come up with, but banks.
Banks, excellent. We also said fire stations. Go give thank you gifts to the first line workers.
And what are good thank you gifts? What are good ideals? Because most of those are men. So maybe hand lotions?
Yeah. Hand lotions, sunscreen for the station.
Mm-hmm. Men's cologne and skin care.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because we get those samples that they're using.
And shaving cream.
There are samples of the men's colognes. They still have some samples out there. I'm sorry, I didn't hear somebody else said something.
Kathy said that the shaving cream, do they have samples of shaving cream?
No.
Just buy them one.
Yeah. Some of this, it could be that you take them some cookies and, you know, a little care package and put your sunscreen lip balm. Hello. So sometimes a little bit of this is thinking outside the box for this, hopefully. Room one, did you have anything else?
No, I think you covered ours.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Nail salons, we didn't like officially say that. Of course, any of your restaurants, but also your departments, your stores, your department stores, your TJ Maxx's, today, I met the sweetest girl at Hallmark. She was very sweet. Because, some of these stores don't have a lot of foot traffic, which is the one thing that when COVID wasn't, you didn't want to be rude to the cashier because you want to make sure she could do her job. Well, she really doesn't mind visiting with you right now because a lot of them, especially in some of these other stores, they have time. they would like to visit with you. Yes. So, I mean, Sophia kind of brought that up earlier as well. So, you know, be, you know, kind of be brave. I mean, be brave, be out there. Now, I'm not asking you to endanger your life, but in the same breath, okay, what are some common sense things that you're going to do going in and out of these places? What are some common sense things you're going to do? You're yes, Kathy.
You're going to use hand sanitizer.
Yes. I hand sanitize my hands on the way in. I hand sanitize my hands on the way out.
And when you get home, you wash your hands for 20 seconds and sanitize them again.
I mean, I hand sanitize my hands. I also hand sanitize my steering wheel and my phone. Every time I get back in the car, I'm spraying it all over my hands, run the wheel, rubbing my phone. So just, I mean, you know, I'm wearing my mask, you know, so just use, but you know, comment, you know, a little bit of this is the world isn't scary. Just go be, you know what I'm saying? Go be there. Okay. So we're going to do one more thing back in the room. I promise there is some other training. I am not just trying to avoid not doing my training. I promise I do. Got it, guys. I'm not trying to avoid it. So the last thing I want to do in our last thing in our room, did you notice that Sophia led the question? How many times do you touch that hand sanitizer in a day? Did you notice that just, whoop, I mean, she was so very innocently, but she was totally leading them to get an answer that was going to be helpful. Does that make sense? Yes. Okay. So when we break into the room, okay, how many times do you use hand sanitizer? That question is taken. We don't all get to repeat that question. Okay? We've used it. Well, you can write it down because tomorrow when you go out, you totally can use it tomorrow. You just can't use it in the breakout rooms right now. What's another question that makes logical sense to ask somebody? Because remember, she also said she's helping them solve a problem. We're problem solvers. And if we want a good answer, we ask good questions. Making sense? Everybody's following me. So now what we're going to do in the room, I want us to come up with some good questions. What are some other questions besides, hey, how many times do you use hand sanitizer? I want us to come up with some other, you know, maybe you and your group, maybe that you might get one, you might get two. I don't believe we're going to have 25 questions in a room, okay? I don't believe this is all that is the same, but I do want us to kind of think, what are some other leading questions? Everyone know what their room assignments are now? Okay, so we are going to go jump into our breakout rooms. I think everybody ends up in the same room, but you know, who knows? I'm trying. So we'll see you when you get there. See you when you get back. Leading questions.
Awesome. Judy? Judy. 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 Gotcha.
And we're back. Okay, so did that open up your brain to think in a different way? So what, I mean, how many see warm chatting or whatever you want to call it now in a different light? Yes?
Well, because,
I mean, because basically you're problem solving. And so part of it is that asking the right question, you know, what are some of the questions that your group came up with? Judy, you want to go with one?
Talking about the face, you know, has your face dried under this mask?
Mm-hmm.
Have you developed any skincare problems under this mask? That type of thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And them playing with their mask, or as we said, wearing them in a unique way. It's kind of a good way to lead that question. Hey, mm-hmm. are you getting kind of itchy under your mask? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Suzette, what was one under yours?
One is about tired eyes or dark circles with the hydrogel eye patches.
Excellent. Excellent. We also talked about having people that have sunburns. So kids playing in the pool. So the after sun gel or the sunscreen. Because kids are out and about and things like that. FYI, the sunscreen, because it's not slimy or sticky, UIL had, it's safe for UIL baseball, tennis, golf, because there leaves no residue on the apparatus. So that might also be, you know, something with people out, you know. Part of it is, like when my daughter went through tennis, that was a fundraiser we did with the tennis group, is that I sold it, they bought Mary Kay sunscreen, and part of my, you know, instead of giving my hostess credit, I gave, instead of doing hostess credit, the team got it in cash, but I just paid my hostess credit to the team. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Did anybody follow me on what I said? So, I mean, thinking outside, I mean, because people are, I mean, the bands are still marching, people. The tennis teams are still, you know, playing on the courts. And just kind of think out there. People still definitely need us. Okay, so did you guys find in-person training ideas helpful? Was this a helpful part of it? Okay, so the part I'm going to talk about is online, because the cool thing about COVID is equally and the same, it's opened up. Everything Sophia talked about, we were doing that or hoping we were doing that pre-COVID. Well, we had an online presence COVID, before COVID, but how many like me, our online presence has gotten a whole lot bigger? Well, oh wait, you're all on Zoom, obviously. We're doing more things online, right? Mm-hmm. So one of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to share my screen again, see if I can get this right. Share. And hopefully you are all seeing my Facebook page. Is that correct? You are seeing my Facebook page?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so I'm gonna point out a couple things out here on Facebook that hopefully if you are not already doing this, please consider doing this. One thing I hope you have, you're a part of this 92,900 members of the My Mary Kay group. My Mary Kay group, not My Mary Kay page, not My Mary Kay life. I want you to be a part of the My Mary Kay group. The reason I want you to be there is this is a private group that Mary Kay Corp has put out there to help us stay even more current of what is going on. Yes, my downloads are going really slow. There is also training videos out here like today. So I'm going to highly recommend you join this group. Then I'm going to go recommend that you listen to, well, I really like today's 30-minute training because the girl who is in the head of our social media, so she's the one, if you were at New Year's kickoff, she was on, plus one person from MK Legal. They teamed up to give us 30 minutes worth of training on social media. Does anybody else think that that might be a good half an hour of your life spent? Okay, so it's out here in the My Mary Kay group. Okay, is anyone caught on where I would really like you to be is in the group? Okay, because if you go to the other place, you're not going to see the trainings. Okay, so part of the whole thing is they're going to be talking about the difference between having your regular page and your business page. Okay. The other thing they're going to be talking about is Instagram and having an Insta. So there's a private page on Instagram and a public and a business page on Instagram. The other cool thing that they talked about, oh, I don't know if you know this. On your Mary Kay InTouch page, under resources, they have now updated the digital zone. Okay? Social Media Central. Because before, they would do some training, and then it kind of like put a drop of ink in water and it kind of dissipated all over the InTouch page and you could never really find that amazing training again. It is all, they have all centralized it. It is all right here under the social media guide, Media Central. It is all, so digital basics. How do I do my Mary Kay Facebook group? What are our digital assets? How can I set up my personal website? How can communications and Mary Kay email? What are all the apps and what are they for? And how do I make them work? All in uno place. Anybody else thinking this might be helpful for us to know where this is? Okay, a couple things, the big things. When it comes to social media, I've made this comparison. I've talked about it before just because those of you who know where Judy Statz lives, Judy Statz lives relatively close to 183. Not exactly at 183, but relatively close to 183. Like if we put up a 40 foot flagpole and put a pink flag on top of it, you could see it from 183. You're going to have to know where to look on 183. because you're zooming by it to know where to look to find Judy's 40-foot fleck. The same is true when it comes to social media. Social media is amazing, but everybody's zooming by at a very high rate of speed. And what you're trying to do is you're trying to get people to engage with you. Does that make sense? What the actual goal? Stop sharing. You're sharing some stuff. I've got somebody on. Okay. So when we are doing our social media, our big goal is to help people engage with you. So on my private page, I'm just going to give you a couple of things that happened today. Today, the UPS person dropped my seminar box. Well, he delivered it. He didn't drop it. He delivered it. This happens to be the seminar box that actually has my jewelry in it. How do I know that? It's because it says that a grown-up over 21 was supposed to sign for it. Another story about my UPS person, but we'll let that one go. So I know what's inside. I know what's inside of it. And so on my Facebook page, I put a picture of, oh my gosh, thank God I only have to wait 4 days. This is so hard. Why did I do that? Because it's a part of my journey of being in Mary Kay. People have heard that, you know, thanks to COVID, we're not meeting in person, right? It's Dallas. They've all missed us. We should have been there. We're not. No pink, you know. And so I'm telling the story to engage them to like me. A couple days ago on there, it was National Siblings Day, and I posted a picture of my boys and my daughter, and my kids affirming who they were. Another, I don't know when it was, Saturday was Dakota's 3-year anniversary of living with us. You should see how fat he's gotten in 3 years. I'm just saying, you live with me, you're gonna fatten up. That's just what happens, get over it. So it was a celebration of Dakota being here 3 years. I've had a, you know, when the lip balms came out, hey, this is my, look at this berry color. Oh, how exciting. Okay, I'm interweaving on my regular page life. They're falling in love with Mary. Mary happens to be a mom. She happens to be a wife. She happens to love Jesus. And she happens to sell Mary Kay. And that's, if anybody looks at my Facebook page, they should have no doubt about any of the above. Because you see, my Facebook page, my private page, is helping people fall in love with Mary. Okay? The thing is, if they're my friend on my Facebook page, I then can invite them to follow my business page. Okay? On my business page, I can say, hey, would you like a pampering packet? Because a business is, I can ask for a transaction. I cannot, and this isn't a Mary Kay rule. This is a direct selling company. This is a Facebook rule. And why it's a Facebook rule is, how many of you have ever seen ads on Facebook? You know, it says sponsored. That's how Facebook makes its money, people. They want to sell sponsorships. They don't want you putting up commerce. They don't want sales happening without you paying Facebook, because Facebook is a business. You following me? So part of this is I am getting strategic And I'm getting ways to form relationships because Facebook wants me to buy ads. I want my friends to see me and be engaged so I remember them and they remember me, so I can bring it up in conversation. It's a proximity thing, kind of like what Sophia was talking about. She has to walk into the right restaurant to actually ask that waitress. Okay, on Facebook, I'm posting about the dog, I'm posting about fun flowers, because I'm trying to figure out where are my friends and customers. Because if all of a sudden it's like, hey, it's Aunt Becky's birthday, I can then private message Aunt Becky, happy birthday, Aunt Becky. Okay, and put it on her wall. Happy birthday, you know, put a fun gift out there, right? And then in a private message, I could say, FYI, I don't know that you know, but all my birthday customers get 10% off the week of their birthday, any order. I can private message her because now I've engaged with Aunt Becky. Is everybody I'm leading the questions. Like what Sophia does in person, that is what I'm watching for on Facebook. And then I can engage them in conversation. Am I making sense to people? But those of you, I can see your heads, okay? Now, part of this is you've got to know where to look for people and who you're looking for. I know we have skincare that anybody can be our customer, okay? I understand that. Anybody can be our customer. I totally understand that. But I want to put it into this perspective. You and your family are going out to eat. Is there a more annoying answer than I don't care? Is there more an annoying answer than that? I don't care. It doesn't matter. I always swore that if I'd ever open a restaurant, I'd name it either it doesn't matter or I don't care, because then everybody's coming to my place. Because that's all they ever say. Okay? Marketing at its best. Okay. But if we know who, okay, I'm going to just kind of walk through who I love. I work with anybody. I love working with everybody. But if I had my favorite people to work with, it is somebody that has never been taught how to wear makeup. She's not confident in her skincare. And she's busy as all heck. Do you know who I just described? Me, pre-Mary Kay. You see, I know I'm not the only human out there that was not taught about skincare, that was not taught about makeup. And because I wasn't taught those two things, I didn't have a lot of confidence in my skin. 11 years has done me good. I can show you photos. So I'm looking for busy people that are average. I'm not going out because my ideal customer for moi, Miss I don't wear lipstick most of the time, I'm not going to the makeup sites. Because guess what? My girl's not going to be looking there. Does that make sense? So part of this is who, because the unfocused mind doesn't know what to focus on. If you listened to Sophia's where she's going in a path that follows her life. She's going to stores, she's going to grocery stores, she's going to other stores to help stock her other store and restaurants and karaoke, because that is her interest areas. I bet she didn't list a craft store because that's not exactly where Sophia hangs out. Not that she can't, but she's more likely to be seen at karaoke. Does that make sense? Not that she can't go shopping at South Lake, but she is more likely to be shopping in Mansfield and South Arlington. Am I making sense? Part of what, if for this to work, for social media to work, a little bit of this is who you be. This is why we keep coming back to this. Who are you? Who would you like to attract? Because Janice is gonna attract a different customer than Lizette, than Kristen, than Lena. And guess what? Mary Kay, we're doing great. We have 8% of the US market. That means 92% of the people are not on Mary Kay yet. You have 92% of the population to not argue with each other about, but to help bring them to the pink bubble world. Does that make sense? Okay, so that when it comes to social media, you're helping them fall in love with you. And then you're going to spend a set amount of time looking and loving on them. I am not, do not accuse me, nor in any way are you going to hear me say, I give you permission to be on Facebook for 8 hours a day because I'm looking for my ideal client. I didn't say it, nor do I think it'll work. At most, I would be out there doing that maybe a half an hour, 45 minutes. Because you living life and you being out being you is going to be that energy that's going to attract people to you. All of us know people that don't give off energy. Or if they're giving off energy, it's not the energy you want. What are you doing to help build yourself to be an energy giver? You're an energy giver the more that you are being you and that you love you. I'm going to go back to a comment that Judy made earlier. It was like, Judy, we didn't talk about this, but it was like, boom, yes, we're going to say yes. Did you hear Judy say something to the effect, Judy, you can kind of correct me if I didn't get it exactly right. Do we fear more about what other people say or do what are who God made us to be? You see, are you more fearful that someone's going to tell you no? Or are you more fearful that God's given you the task to go be a gift giver and step out there and say, hey, how many times do you touch that hand sanitizer? Are you getting a little itchy under that mask too? Okay. You're right. Everyone's not going to say yes. But everybody doesn't say yes to everything anyway. So let's not expect it. Because I guarantee right now I have a basketball game. I don't know that you can hear it. It's getting close to the Mavericks playing, so it's going to get really loud at my house here shortly. Every time Luca throws up a basketball, it's not going to go in the hoop. It'd be awesome if it would, but it ain't going to happen. But he does it often enough that that's what makes him the superstar. Because he's practiced his craft. You are going to practice your craft of offering this amazing skincare and opportunity. I also love it. Did you hear that Sophia has a paper copy with her that people can see what they're signing up for? What a concept. Things in people's hands because people need focus. What I'd like to do at the end of this, I would like, as I'm closing here, before I turn it off to Judy for rec, I would like you to say a takeaway. What is at least one thing that you are implementing in the next 24 hours? What is one thing you are going to do in the next 24 hours? Because you see, if you don't do it in the next 24 hours, you are at a 95% chance you will never do it. I don't like those odds. So could we do it in the next 24 hours? You had three directors help train you. So let's pick on the one who wants to come join us and be one of our trainers. So Miss Suzette, we're gonna start right over there at your camera. You two get to give us each a takeaway, please. You're on mute.
Sorry.
No, I told you to do that part.
No, right? My takeaway, just not being afraid to talk to anybody, walk up and find an opening that you can speak to anybody and everybody. So you have to walk through that fear.
Excellent. And your new person?
Miss Rhonda.
Miss Rhonda.
One thing that you're going to take away.
Oh gosh. Just constantly looking for an in, you know, looking for questions, a way to lead in.
Excellent.
How you can help, you know, sell something.
Excellent. Welcome. Miss Lizette, we're just gonna kind of go around my screen. It's not gonna be anywhere near your pattern, but this way I don't lose anybody. Miss Lizette. I know, I make you get off the couch. So mean. You're muted, sweetheart, you're muted. Lizette, you're still muted.
Okay, yes, I'm sorry. All right, yeah, I think probably the one thing that you're talking about being afraid because you're gonna get a no. Mm-hmm. And, you know, in thinking about it, so what? Because once you get those yeses, it's like, oh my gosh, you've made a new friend. You know, basically when we say, we feel like we're going to get a no, it's because we're afraid they don't like us and that kind of stuff. So, and think of it as getting a no and hurting your feelings. It's more like saying yes and making a new friend.
Love that. Great takeaway there. Miss Kristen, and then Christy, you're after Kristen.
I would just say the confidence and believing in yourself and that God's always there no matter what.
Excellent. Love that. Christy or Guts?
I would have to say that one of the takeaways is talk to more people.
Yeah.
And like using Sophia's, how many times do you use hand sanitizer a day? Or the lotion?
Uh-huh. Love it. Love it.
Carry product with you.
Yep, excellent. Judy Buchanan.
She may not be able to unmute. She is at the doctor's office.
Got it. Teresa? She may or may not. Vicki, I'm going to be coming to you next. Teresa may or may not be able to unmute as well. Vicki, there you go. Vic, go ahead.
I think on the, what my takeaway was on the Facebook, make sure that you do your business on the private page.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Miss Bozina?
Oh, hello. Here. Yep. Here I am. I'm sorry. Multitasking. I always get orders when I'm on Zoom. Okay. Well, my biggest give takeaway is to be a good energy giver anywhere I go. And if it's physically or virtually on my Facebook page, dealing with clients at my job, or even going to the grocery store, to give out good energy and positive vibes to attract more people.
Excellent. Miss Janice.
I had to miss a lot of it because I lost my thing. So I missed two groups. So hopefully I can find out what everybody talked about. But anyway, okay. show that your life on Facebook for you to your friends to want to join your business page, because they enjoy what you're doing with your life. Just keep up with you.
Yep. Yep. Excellent. Toya, can you unmute? Maybe. Lily, I'm going to be coming to you after Toya. Lily, Toya, there he is.
What I learned.
Mm-hmm.
My takeaway.
Yes, ma'am.
It's going to be, I'm going to be contacting Sophia for some more of those insights. The quote in the beginning, I like when Ms. Judy give us quotes and stuff with acting out of fear, thinking about what others are thinking instead of what God is planning for our business. So that little, that nudge right there.
Yep. Yeah. Excellent. Thanks, Toya. Lily, you're up. Lily, I lost you.
I like what's, pardon?
Yeah, go ahead.
She was always, Sophia said she was always prepared when she went and saw a person. She always had her bag with her, her sample, her book, even though it was an old book. Always
absolutely
had her old book and explained to everybody understands the COVID, you know? So I like the way she was always prepared.
Excellent. I agree. Miss Lena, can you unmute? Or are you at a spot that's not safe?
And then can you hear me?
Yeah, we can.
Okay. Basically, I've never been afraid to talk to no one. So that's not been an issue. Mine is I found out that getting more on social media and doing videos, I got a lot of messages asking about applications of makeup and stuff like that. So I've been trying to listen to my customers about what they want.
Excellent. Excellent. Cassandra.
My takeaway is the fear, getting over the fear, the rejection.
Yeah. And I hope you heard Miss Judy say that. False evidence appearing real. And I think most of us have probably heard that there's 365 references to fear not in the Bible. He's got every day covered, people. He's got every day covered. The last thing before I turn it back over to Miss Judy to go ahead and then Sophia to close us out. Sometimes you just have to invest in yourself to make sure that you give off that positive energy. I told you that I ended up at Hallmark today, right? Okay, so when I was there, they had one of my favorite clearances, 75% off. I'm telling you, I'm the queen of seeing sales, okay? I love sales. 75% off, it's going to get me to at least walk by. I've been looking for a new water bottle. It has a flamingo on it. Now look at this. Feels good to be a queen. You know why? Because sometimes you just got to keep in your head who you really be. I'm a queen because I'm a daughter of the Most High King. It's not about what I did, Mary Kay, but you know, if I keep remembering who I be, I'm going to be sending out that energy. So, Miss Judy, let's send it back over to you to give some recognition, and Sophia's got the night to close us out.
Yes, and one thing more I wanted to mention about seminar real quick is the fact that you've got the opportunity to donate to the Mary Kay Foundation. And during that time, when you do, there's different prizes and gifts for you, and one of them being the Kendra Scott earrings that only Mary Kay people can have that have picked them up at seminar. So even though we've got 4 seminars going on simultaneously, and this is more than my little mind can even begin to put together, remember to donate to the Mary Kay Foundation. It was Mary Kay Ash Foundation for a long time. Well, I'm thrilled over what you all have done this last week. Directors, you're going to be ecstatic over it also. And so, in the faces category, our number 3 is Kathy with one face. Congratulations. California is still going no matter what. And Suzette, congratulations. She had three new faces this past week. And Bozina, congratulations for being our queen with four new faces. Everybody give her a big round of applause. You bet. Because that is great. This is one of the ways that we keep things moving. And then, of course, from that, we have our bookings because you always want to continue in business. And Kathy, again, had one new booking. Congratulations, Kathy. Bozina had two. And our queen for the evening, who's driving across country, Lena, has four new bookings. And congratulations, Lena, for being our queen of bookings. I love the fact that we had nearly all of you turn in at least some sales. Gang, this is one of the ways that Mary Kay says that we continue her legacy is to continue to sell. And so we want to make sure that we're doing that. Our number three position is Suzette. Please give her a round of applause. Number two was Vicky. Way to go. And our queen and two queens for tonight, Bozina, 447. And congratulations, Bozina, because we just know that that means you're talking to your people. And congratulations on getting orders during Zoom. You know, tough life there, my dear. And then, of course, sharing this business. This is when you get to share the heart of Mary Kay is when you're doing this. And congratulations, Bozina. And congratulations, Christy. They were number three and number two, respectively. And our queen of sharing was Suzette with eight different interviews, career chats. Congratulations. She is moving into DIQ and CAR and all of those other kinds of wonderful places. And so she's making that focus very real. And new team members, Christy, woo, has one new team member. Way to go, Christy. And Suzette is our queen with two new team members for the week. And I bet one of them is sitting right beside you, isn't she? Congratulations, Rhonda, for joining a dynamite team and making this an awesome decision as you're moving forward in becoming all that God meant for you to be. So I believe, Sophia, it is time to get to hear from you. And I remind everybody, let's all work at being at seminar this week and donating so that Mary Kay Foundation can touch the lives that you and I personally might not ever see. Sophia.
Okay. Well, today I want to talk about resetting, pushing the reset button for your goals. And also about courage, both of those things. And I looked for some stories that had to do with both, but I think what I'm going to go ahead and do is just talk about the two things. One is when it comes to resetting your goals, and sometimes things don't always work out. The month didn't maybe go as you planned. You know, when you're looking at the end of last month, at the end of the month, you're looking at the beginning of the month thinking in August, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to have so many, I'm going to have a recruit and so many interviews, and you have all your goals laid out for you, and you don't quite hit those goals by when you want to, let's say the 15th of the month, you divide out that month. We still have another whole half of the month in August. We still have plenty of time to hit those goals. So first of all, just forgive yourself if you're not exactly where you want to be. Just forgive yourself. That's yesterday. Forgiven, forgotten. You need to do that for yourself first. And you need to separate yourself from those things. This is not necessarily who you are. You are not the goal, okay? You still have a beautiful vision. You still have a wonderful goal of what you want to achieve. And it's still there in front of you, and it's still there for your taking. So you separate yourself from the first part of the month. And like I always like to say, I can't drink yesterday's water. We are on today. We are going to do this today. The second is, another one is hard work is hard work. And you can achieve certain things with hard work, but you also have to have a good attitude. When you're striving for your goals, keep a positive attitude And that also improves your work productivity, that energy, that positive energy that Mary and Judy were talking about, you know, keeping that positive energy, walking in there and you're solving a problem for folks. You are the answer for a lot of folks. And you just get rid of the toxic element of any kind of resentment or doubt, fear, get rid of it. Get rid of any, just scoot that out of your mind. Fear could be something like, I'm not smart enough. I'm not fast enough. I'm not brave enough. I'm not going to say the right words. There's never a perfect time to walk up to someone and start a conversation. It's never perfect. So get that idea of perfection just out of your mind, because you are going to be you. God made you perfect already. So another thing I want you to remember is that as far as courage goes, you really become passionate about what you want. If you have your goal, and Suzette can tell you she's got her goal. She is passionate about that car. She is passionate about DIQ. You put that in your mind, and that is where you want to be. And a means to get there is getting out there and putting yourself out there and introducing yourself to people and talking to new people. Focus on the goal and the achievement and seeing yourself doing that. That's why, kind of why we create the vision board, you know, in January. That's when I created my vision board and I had a car right up in there. So that's something to focus on, something wonderful to focus on. And sometimes despite how much you prepare and you try and you talk to someone and it does not matter. Sometimes it doesn't work out. You know, sometimes it's no, I'm not interested. Go away. That's okay. You shake it off, you brush it off, and you go on and you keep your positive attitude. You know who you are, and you go on and you speak to the next person, bring your positive energy with you. You can just remember Thomas Edison had 1,000 failures. He logged every single one of them in his journal. He had almost 1,000 failures before he came up with the light bulb, before he successfully completed it. So that's one thing I want you to remember, is just believe in yourself.
Well, thank you, Miss Sophia. You are definitely a role model for us to believe, and putting that vision out there. It has been very fun watching you put that out there and chase it and make it happen. Speaking of celebrating Sophia and her team, please, please, please put Monday, 2 Mondays from tonight, August 31st, we're going to be in person at Farang Villa celebrating Sophia and her team. It will be a guest event. Yes, we will be wearing masks, but we want to celebrate that night. We will be there. Thank God Farang is a large place. So, you know, hey, we could have lots of people there and still be very much socially distance safe. So please, that will be a night that we will be in Mary Kay attire. So yes, no shorts and t-shirts. No shorts and t-shirts. We will be in Mary Kay dresses. You're going to actually see the new director suits. You're going to see Sophia. She's going to be debuting in her suit. We're so excited about that. So red jackets, please have your red jackets on. Yes, please have guests with you. We will be starting promptly at 6:30 at Farang Villa. So please, please, if you can arrange your schedule, we would love to have you be there with us celebrating this amazing team and just celebrating the fact that we're together and that together we always achieve more. So thank you for your time tonight. Tomorrow night at 8:00, we will be doing our favorite things. I am looking for volunteers to be sharing products. Volunteer early. You have a higher probability of getting the product you want, and it's a lot less likely I will draft you. So speak early or be drafted. That is kind of how that works. And on Thursday night at 8 o'clock, we will also be having a guest event talking more about masks. So kind of that lead-in question that Sophia kind of sets us up for. So both Tuesday and Thursday is at 8 o'clock. Okay, we did move them both to 8 o'clock, right?
Isn't it? Seminar starts Thursday?
Yes. Seminar starts Thursday, so we won't be meeting Thursday night.
We will not be meeting Thursday night.
Yeah.
Isn't that the short night though?
Well, see, those of us in Go Give, we have a meeting.
Okay, so those of you go give. That's why, because I'm not in Go Give.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's why I didn't register. Let's just not. I will move my guest. I can do that. So let's just not this Thursday night. So Tuesday night, we have guest events. So
Saturday morning we still can.
And then
because that doesn't start
Saturday morning, we can still do it, right?
Yes. Yeah, we sure can, because that's at 10, okay. And then Mary Kay is at 1.
I would highly recommend finding as many people as possible for Tuesday, but especially Saturday morning. We will have started the pink bubble energy, and Saturday morning's just gonna feel different. There's no way to explain it. You're just gonna feel different. I would be seriously stacking as many bodies on Saturday morning at 10 o'clock. Just for the record, I don't know about you, but I do get a little bit competitive. The Colorado group had 50 guests on.
50 guests on what?
They had a guest event.
Oh.
They did a guest event and they had 50 guests. I don't know about you, but it kind of rubs me a little bit the wrong way that Colorado pulled off 50.
Like on Zoom, 50 guests on Zoom. I don't even know what that was.
I'm thinking Saturday morning. I think 60 would be awesome. It's seminar, people.
We can do it. We can do it.
Okay. Just for the record, people, that means each of us would show up with two guests. I'm not saying each of you bring 60 guests. Well, I mean, you could. But really, if we each just showed up with two guests, we would have 60 people there. Two guests doesn't sound unrealistic, does it? Lizette, does two guests sound unrealistic?
Not if you just...
I think two guests. So, Saturday morning...
Yeah, 50 is nothing if each of us...
Apparently, I'm cracking.
Huh?
Right. My computer was cracking out. I was losing you. So, tomorrow night at 8, Saturday at 10. No Thursday. Our goal, how many guests? We're going to blow out Colorado. Because it's what I do. Okay? Everybody cool? Okay. You guys, see you tomorrow night. Have a great night, y'all.